Let's start with a quick introduction to object orientation and the fundamental concepts behind it. And let's start by discussing what exactly is object orientation. If you're younger than me, it could be that the first programming language you learned was already an object-oriented language. But things were not always like this. Before object orientation became prevalent, people were not used to think in terms of objects. So what happened afterwards, and what does it mean to think in terms of objects and to follow an object-oriented approach? First of all, it means to give precedence of data over function. Data items, rather than functionality, become the center of development activities. This also allows for enforcing the very important concept of information hiding, which is the encapsulation and segregation of data behind well-defined and ideally stable interfaces in order to be able to hide design and also implementation decisions. And note that the terms encapsulation and information hiding are often used interchangeably. Although some people prefer to think of information hiding as being the principle and encapsulation being the technique to achieve information hiding. The key concept, though, no matter which term you use, is really to gather, to seclude this data behind sort of a wall and give access to the data only through interfaces that you, the developer, define. And why is that important? Well, for many reasons. And one of the main ones is that it makes code more maintainable. Because the rest of the code, the rest of the system, doesn't have to be concerned on how the implementation details or the design are defined. And therefore, any change that happens behind this wall doesn't concern the rest of the system and doesn't affect the rest of the system as long as you keep your interfaces consistent. Another advantage of focusing on objects and encapsulating the information into cohesive entities is that it allows the reuse of object definitions by incremental refinement, which is what we normally call inheritance. And inheritance is definitely a fundamental concept in object orientation. For example, we can define a car as a refinement of a vehicle that has some additional characteristics with respect to a generic vehicle, and then we can use the car wherever a vehicle can be used, which is what we call polymorphism. And we continued this discussion for a very long time because there are so many things that could be discussed when we talk about object orientation, its characteristics, and its advantages. But in the interest of time, let's for now just stop here and start talking about two key concepts in object orientation.